you are. Big hands, I know you're the one. Is that a reference to, like, heroin use?
Let's look that up.
Yeah, but I think that perspective is, like, always susceptible to change. And I guess, like, you know, when I was younger, before I had a boyfriend, I always knew that, like, waiting until marriage and, like, being a wife and a mom was, like, the ideal situation, you know? But I also knew that I wasn't gonna do that. And even though I was really in love with, like, every guy that I've been with, I could never imagine marrying the motherfucker and having his babies. And so I asked myself the question, why the fuck did I even do that? You know? So true. Everybody has a permanent record now. Thanks to social media. I mean, now everything's out in the open, and I guess it's kind of good because, like, people can't keep running away from the truth anymore. Which is why it's like everybody acts so fake. It's literally because they're lying to themselves about everything all the time. They've been doing that their entire life. And now that social media has revealed everything, it's just really obvious who the fakers are. It's really obvious, like, who enjoys being lied to, you know? Check over here. And then a convenience store. Yeah. I think about, like, third world countries a lot. And how, like, whenever you complain about anything, like, you're just gonna sound a certain way. You know, like, if you complain about capitalism, you're gonna sound like a fucking leftist loser that, like, just whines about, you know, this whole, like, idea of, like, oppression and, like, people being taken advantage of. And, like, yeah, that's true. Like, that shit doesn't refrain from being true, but it still doesn't make it any less annoying when people whine about it as if they're gonna actually do anything about it. And I think that's what the most annoying thing about politics is, like, all these people are just whining, but they don't really have any solutions, and they just want to keep trusting the system. But I think that, like, to not trust the system is a lot more, like, of a leftist persuasion. Because the right likes their order, but you can say that it's because of, like, leftist infiltration. And that, you know, Marxism. And, you know, this whole, like, putting people into all these little groups. But the thing is, people on the right do that too. So if you're either ultra-right or ultra-left, like, you're putting people in boxes. But I don't really know if it's, like, in the middle. Like, I mean, I don't think I'm in the middle. I just feel drunk. Like, every single time that I'm trying to talk about politics, I'm like, did I relapse? I'm gonna have to put on my real shoes. So, like, I work at essentially a fast food restaurant. It didn't used to be a fast food restaurant, but it's kind of obviously a fast food restaurant. But I've always worked in, you know, shittier restaurants. And I think the nicest restaurant I worked at was, like, this, like, Americanized Asian diner that was kind of a knockoff of P.F. Chang's. And, I worked there for, like, 7 months or so. I trained a transgender person, and this transgender person is, like, the whole reason I started doing stand-up comedy. Well, I don't want to give him, her, question mark, all the credit for this, but needless to say, the bitch thought I was funny, okay? But she was also psychotic. Psychotic people tend to find me funny, right? Whether they're psychotic because they think they were born in the wrong body, or they think that the government's always out to get them. But because I work in the restaurant industry and I see these families, I see families come in all the time. And, you know, working in the drive-thru service, I would see the same families every single day giving their kids all this crap food. And I know that people get into their habits and their routines and everything, and I know that fast food is real easy and convenient, you know, it's everywhere. I'm at a convenience store right now, against my will, but now I need tweezers. I need tweezers bad, I can't find them. But they don't have these little mom and pop shops, at least not around here, that just have, you know, a bunch of shit that I need. And, I will say this, though. If there's something that I could either do without or something that I could just make, I'd rather do that. Just like, I had a bunch of people telling me to go to the doctor because of my finger. But I just didn't want to do it. So whose advice did I take? The fucking unconventional nutritionist that, you know, shares my views on inoculation and he was like, don't go to the doctor. You don't need a doctor. What are they going to do for you? And so he just told me, yeah, pour essential oil into it. Yeah. It really is healing. I think this is my favorite song on the whole album. You could say that this was an incel song before incels were a thing. Yeah, but you know, men have always had problems with women, and women have always had problems with men, and women have always had problems with women, and men have always had problems with men. Society is screwed up, and it's always been screwed up, and it's not going to get any easier with inventions, you know? Interesting that this song is called Add It Up. Like, adding it up is what society is doing constantly, and they don't know, like, the devastating effect of this equation, because they're not really paying attention. Like, somebody like me is adding it up. You know, all this stuff, like, it's just piling on society. All these pressures, all these extra pressures, all these extra conflicts of interest, you know. They weaponize biology. They weaponize psychology. America's too stupid to ask questions and pay attention to their own experience and pay attention to things that are happening all around them. And this is not a leftist or, you know, a rightist, whatever you want to say, perspective. It's just, like, I feel like I have a whole, like, full spectrum bird's eye view of this. Whereas, like, people can call it whatever they want to call it, but, like, you're just offended that I'm not like you, honey. That's what everybody's offended about. Like, if you want to just whittle it down, it's pretty simple. People are mad that other people aren't them and don't think like them and don't approach things the way they do. There are a lot of skinny dudes that want to fuck fat bitches. I'll never understand it, but that exists, all right? People, you know, they're into what they're into. There are a lot of people that love the fuck out of food. I don't, obviously. I'm like 90 pounds, if that. But, you know, there are a lot of people. I'm about to go see my friend who's really overweight, and he's trying to lose weight right now. But, yeah, he's always been a big-ass dude. And a lot of people have just always had a weight problem. Just like there are people that have always been, like, more into sex. Like, they have a much higher sex drive. It's hard for them to say no to that sort of thing. And a lot of these people end up getting in bad situations. They get somebody pregnant. And, you know, they have a kid out of wedlock, and the kid's fucked up, and... You know, like, I see these experiences all the time because I work in fast food. So I know so many people that, you know, are just making foolish decisions. They're on a bunch of drugs, you know. A lot of these people are addicted to pills. Whether they're addicted to, you know, like, Percocets and, you know, Oxycontin or, what's that other one a lot of people like? Vicodin, Valium, whatever the fuck. Like, whether they're fun drugs or not fun drugs. And by not fun, I mean, like, you shoot up schools and bars and stadiums and things like that. You know, that doesn't sound too fun. So there are those drugs that people are addicted to. But, you know, everybody at my work's, like, smoking pot all the time. And... I've known people that have overdosed, okay? I know, like, I think I count on one hand. Which I guess isn't an impressive number, but, I mean, it, like, I think it is. Like, the fact that I know, like, at least 5 people that have fucking died over pills. Like, there was this guy at Steak and Shake. He was fucking 18, and he overdosed on fentanyl. He was snorting all kinds of pills, and so, you know, just the fact that he was so young and he completely threw his life away like that, and I got into some pretty good conversations with this kid too. It just makes me really sad, but, like, this is the reality of it. You know, people just aren't really paying attention to the stuff that they're doing to themselves. You know, you have people that are watching TV and they get all kinds of ideas. They want to be on TV. They want to be popular. They want to be a celebrity. They want to be talked about. They want to make the headlines. You know, it's like, this culture is so fucking sick, dude. And if it offends you that I complain about capitalism, it's because, look, I see the result of capitalism. I see the result of this ultimate freedom that people have to just stuff their face full of shit food, watch TV nonstop, play video games nonstop, fuck whoever the fuck they want, just throw away the evidence, you know, depending on what state you're in. I mean, it's not as if you can't abort a baby without the help of a doctor. Come the fuck on, women aren't creative at all. You know? Like, there are so many things that people can do that are fucked up and wrong. But you don't need the government to do something fucked up and wrong, but chances are the government is actually going to be cool with that. Like, no matter what people want to say about it. Like, I was thinking about it. It's been, like, over 50 years that abortion's been illegal. Since Roe v. Wade. And because of that... the song. That's what they're doing to babies. They're hacking them apart. They have to pull off their limbs and everything. Like, if it's a third trimester... I mean, it's fucked up, man. But it's really fucked up, like, any way you look at it. Like, you could just be like, okay, I'm just gonna end this life. It doesn't matter, you know? I used to be on the other side of it, by the way. I used to, like, just think that abortion... Like, I didn't understand why people would be against it. Considering, like, how many kids aren't getting taken care of. Considering, like, child abuse and the rates of incest and all that shit, you know? So, it's like, I was looking at those statistics. and I was talking to kids that were abused, you know, things like that. Like, and I just wish that more people would have more conversations with more people. This world would be such a better place if people could just get over themselves and have conversations and, like, be willing to be uncomfortable by somebody else's information that's not convenient for them to hear, you know? People would have to get over, like, this fear that they have of, like, being judged and being called things. But they'd also have to get over themselves in a way. You know, like, their whole experience, them putting their experience on a pedestal and thinking that it's more important because of whatever reason. You see it with race, you see it with religion, you see it with age, you see it with occupation, you see it with gender, you see it with sexual preference. It's like, I'm sorry if this is redundant, because I mean, yeah, this is life, this is society, right? But anyway, I'm going to go get what I need to get. Just try to get the fuck out of here before I get too mad. Because I just hate being in places with a bunch of people that, you know, I complain about on this channel.